In this video, I'm going to show you how to save a file with a macro. So I have a basic form here, and for example, you would fill in your name in this cell here. So let's type in Jones as a last name and press enter. Now, I would like to have a button here that says save file. So we're going to go to our developer tab, and below the toolbox and from the list arrow, we are going to go and get from the ActiveX controls, we're going to get the button icon here. And now we're going to go and save it or put it on our sheet right about here. Now, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to double click this button, and then we have our command button started here. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to define some variables. So I'm going to go dim path as string, and then I'm going to go dim file name 1 as string. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to get what our path is. Now, the easiest way that I know to do this is go to the actual location that you want to save this file on. So I've created a folder called demo on my desktop. So now I'm going to go to that folder. And I'm going to click on the address bar. And there you have the path all spelled out for you. So you go Control C. And then I'm going to go put quotation marks and go Control V. And remember to put the closing backslash on here and your closing quotation marks. And your path's defined for you now. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to define what the file name is. So from our sheet, we see that Jones is located in C4. And so that's what the name I would like this file to be named. So I'm going to go file name 1. Equals range opening bracket quotations C4 quotation marks end brackets dot text. Okay, so now we've defined that, and this file, because it has a macro in it, is a macro enabled file, but I would like to save it as just an ordinary file. So it's going to give me a warning. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to shut off the alerts while this is happening. So I'm going to go Application.DisplayAlerts, and I'm going to go equals false. And so then the next line I'm going to do is I'm going to give it directions on how to save the file. So I'm going to go ActiveWorkbook.SaveAs, and then I'm going to put a space, and I'm going to go file name. Colon and equals, and path that we've defined up there at further up, and then you're going to put an and sign, and you're going to put your file name 1 that you defined, and then you're going to put an and sign, and you're going to go quotation marks dot xlsx. End quotation marks. Okay, and so now what you're going to do is put a comma here, and you're going to specify what the file format is. And so we go file format colon equals xlOpenXMLWorkbook. So that should do that. And now we need to, I think we're good now. I didn't have a space there. And so now let's, application displays back on. And we'll go to true. And now what I'm going to do is close the active workbook once you've saved it. Now, my typing skills aren't up to par, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to debug this to make sure I haven't done any more typing mistakes. Compile it. It seems to be okay. So, now let's go back to our sheet. We're still in the design mode here, so I'm going to right-click on my button, and I'm going to, then I'm going to go to Properties, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the change the caption to save file. Maybe I'll put a space in there. Okay. So now what we're going to do is we're going to save this before we go away. And so now we should, by clicking this file, we should be able to create a file named Jones in our desired location. And then we can click on Save File. And so now let's go to our demo. And there you have your file named Jones, and it's located in the demo folder that we created. And that's how you save a file using a macro. Please subscribe.